And I guess the first thing we need to say to Coach after that easy blowout win, happy birthday, Coach.
Yeah. Thanks, man. We can enjoy a birthday party this year. It's about to commence as soon as we're done here.
Well, and congratulations on your career.
Yeah,
here
unbelievable.
Also.
Yeah. 300.
Yeah,
isn't that something?
Well done.
God,
well done.
You know, there's been so many great players, and we've got great players now. Some of them are just really young, and great coaches, great crowd support, great administration. So I've had a charmed coaching life, and tonight was an example of that.
Well, memorable.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'll remember 300 for a while.
Got to ask you what you were thinking at halftime. You couldn't make any kind of a shot, and 22 points, 24%. It looked like it was headed for a game much like the one up there in Storrs.
You know, basically, I thought we had some pretty good looks. We missed some layups. We missed some dunks. We missed some stick backs. We missed some wide open jumpers. And I asked them, I said, listen, we've tried several different things. What can you guys, how can we score the ball? You know, we can run it, we can give you some organization, but you got to eventually execute and knock down a shot. So I let them tell me, really. They coached the second half. At one point, I challenged them a little bit because I didn't like how the things were going. Maybe it was under 12 or whatever. They scored 10 points in one of the four-minute segments, so there's like 12 minutes to go. And I challenged them in a timeout or media timeout, and they responded.
Your two seniors in particular.
Yeah, they made some big shots. I mean, Samaje was tremendous, obviously, with the last. But Marcus made a couple of threes. We moved the ball a little more crisply in the second half. We were able to get some motion baskets after our play or our quick broke down. We didn't get much from our bigs tonight as far as scoring, but Asbjorn was really big to protecting that goal in the second half.
He was active, I thought, and he had 5 rebounds, but there were a bunch of others that he at least kept in play. Maybe they ended up knocking him out of bounds or one of his teammates.
4 block shots, man. Yeah. 4 block shots for him. 6 total between he and Jamie. And they end up with, 7 rebounds and 6 block shots and 11 points. So that's not bad.
You know, I don't remember the exact score, but I thought what kind of got you going, what kind of just changed the tone, was you got after it on the offensive boards on a miss, and you got 3 offensive rebounds eventually, and Dexter finally got fouled. You never got it back in the basket, but he got fouled, and that just seemed to change the whole momentum a little bit.
Yeah. That was a great play. That was that showed some energy. That was right after the conversation that I'm talking about, and that's what we have to have. We've got to have that extra effort, that mental toughness, the wherewithal to want to go get that basketball. When you shoot under 45% as a team, you got to get extra possessions. And Dexter's really good at that. Marcus is really good at that. Our bigs are good at that. So it was a big key. That was a great possession. I'm glad you picked up on that one.
And you finally won a game at the free throw line.
Yeah, I mean, we were tremendous. We only had 2,000 in the first half. I mean, that's like North Carolina or something. That was amazing. When we just we played without fouling. It wasn't our defense at all in the first half. It was our offense. And then in the second half, you know, it became more of a kind of a game where we were both scoring a little bit more readily.
And then those last 2 threes that Gilbert made, particularly the second one, I'm not sure I've ever seen anything quite like that. It looked like he was trying to draw a 3-shot foul rather than even trying to make it.
Yeah, and I thought we may have fouled him. So I'm just so glad that they didn't call that one. And, you know, had I had it to do all over again and it would have been a dead ball, I might have fouled. But there was still a little too much time. We got 6.4 seconds, plenty of time to get a shot off, and really we've tried to go with the same play that we used against SMU, and we're 2-2 now.
That's a pretty good guy to have it in the hands. He'll make a play for you.
Yeah, he's so quick. And the last time he snaked through to the other side, but this time he acted like he was going and went to that right corner, the floater. It was good the whole way. I was right there on it, and when it left his hands, I knew it was good.
Well, you know he's going to get a shot off. He's just so quick.
Yeah.
He's going to find a shot.
Yeah.
Well, about time one of those went in. Go and celebrate and enjoy your
Absolutely.
Birthday.
Thank you, guys.
Well done.
Thank you so much.
Checker head coach Greg.